Hi, I'm Tamara Witmer with LA's The Place TV, and today we're here with a very special guest, Jane Carrey, of the Jane Carrey Band. Now, you have an album that is out right now called Simple Beauty.
Yes, I do.
That's great. Well, when did you realize that music was your passion?
Music probably became my passion around when I was 14. I was always a ham in school, so I always liked, you know, to be in the school plays and ham it up that way. But I like to, I actually met somebody who really inspired me when I was around 14, and we started writing together, and I soon realized that I could not live without music in my life.
Great. Well, how did you discover that you had such a beautiful and talented voice?
Well, like I said, I always liked to be in the school plays, and I never thought that anything would really come of it. I just liked to be the center of attention. But I started singing jazz with this woman that I spoke of earlier, who inspired me to start writing, and I started taking singing lessons, and it just kind of went from there. I just love to sing, so I think anyone can sing. You go to a village in Africa, and you know, everyone's singing. No one's like, oh, I can't sing.
Well, they can't sing as good as you.
Well, I think everyone has it in them, as long as you let out, you know, how you truly feel. That's singing enough.
Your father is one of the world's greatest comedians and actors. Now, how did his creative influence impact you and your creativity?
Well, I'm not funny, so he didn't influence me in that way. But I definitely come from a family of carnies. You know, we are circus folk, mm-hmm. and he's very supportive in the creative process and me wanting to be in a creative field. And so he likes when I play him my new songs, and he just likes to be involved in any way he can. So he influences me in the sense that he's very supportive, and obviously he's done so well in his career and his life, and he has such an inspirational story that I think anyone would want a piece of what he's done for himself. I mean, you know, so I'm very lucky to be a part of it.
Now, Jane, you have a very interesting style of music. Now, can you tell us a little bit about that and how you decided on that genre of music?
Well, I take from a lot of different genres of music. I think I only listened to rap until I was about 12 years old, so I definitely have a little funk in my step. Mm-hmm. But after that, I started getting into classic rock, and then after classic rock, I got heavily into jazz. So my style of music is just kind of pulling from all of those, and not really rap. I don't rap. I mean, I did on a theme song one time, but it was really bad, so I don't do that anymore. But it's alternative rock with the bluesy jazz influence is how I've always classified it, and it's just pulling from a little of everything.
I don't discriminate.
That's good. It's so unique, too.
Thank you.
Now tell me, who are some of your musical influences?
Well, like I said, I have a lot of classic rock influence, a lot of jazz influence. I love Lynyrd Skynyrd and Queen.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
And Creedence Clearwater Revival, and I love Billie Holiday, you know, Ella Fitzgerald, all the jazz greats, and they, like I said, heavily influenced me.
Now, what about some of the more modern influences of today?
Recently, I'm very influenced by Rufus Wainwright. I think he's a genius.
Also, you know, Sheryl Crow, and but recently I've been really into Brandi Carlile, and I actually went to Las Vegas to see a show with Brandi Carlile and Sheryl Crow.
But it was canceled last minute, so that was
bummer. That would have been a good one.
Yeah, but I think she's amazing. Every time I listen to her album, I just want to go, or her albums, I want to go write music, so.
Mm-hmm. So your album released in September of last year, and did you write your own lyrics and your own songs, or how did you come up with the music?
I did. I came up with the lyrics and the music. I come up with the guitar and the vocals and the lyrics, and then I bring it in to the band, and they make it better.
Right.
You know.
So what is your favorite song on the album and why?
Well, the album's called Simple Beauty. I think probably my favorite song and why we call the album Simple Beauty is because my favorite song is Simple Beauty. Why? I'd say because there's so many, you know, horrible things, and I'm outing myself right now. I'm a huge Star Wars fan, and I believe in, you know, the dark side and the dark side of things. There's always something dark there, you know. But you could choose to see the dark side and see all the dark around you, or you can look around, take a minute, and see all the beautiful things that are everywhere. So that's kind of where the song came from. Not from Star Wars, but just the idea of, you know, being able to see the the simple and beautiful things all around you.
Oh, well, that's really inspiring. That's great.
I understand you just finished your first national tour with Matt Carney. Mm-hmm. How did that come about, and how did you two get together on that one?
Well, we were under the same agency. His agency is based in Nashville, and mine's based in Los Angeles. They hooked us up that way, and I got to open for him on a 2-month national tour, which is pretty awesome.
Oh, wow. So what was your most memorable moment on tour?
Most memorable? That's hard, because we had quite a few of them. It was a great time. Probably the most memorable part was the first night. I was really nervous, and it was the first time I had met Matt and his crew as guitar player and tour manager. And I was really nervous because it was my first show, my first tour, and I told Matt that. And he just kind of looked at me and was like, why don't you tell the audience that? I said, okay, well, that's kind of weird, but sure, why not? So I went out on stage and I told the audience, okay, this is my first show of my first tour. And the whole audience just went crazy. And they loved it. They were so nice, and they just embraced it. And it was really welcoming. And as far as crazy things that had happened on tour, not much crazy happened on tour. It was a very laid-back group of people. It was a nice, nice way to, you know, initiate myself onto the road.
That's great.
Yeah, you hear a lot of crazy stories about musicians, but these guys were really normal. So
there you go.
It was a treat.
That's good. That's always good.
Mm-hmm. So were there any aspects of the tour that really opened your eyes up to anything new or that you weren't aware of going into it?
Well, I think I probably have to bring that back to Simple Beauty, because everywhere I went, even if I was in the middle of nowhere and all you could see was the plains as far as the eye can see, it was so beautiful. It was so gorgeous. Every town we went through, every city had something. And my friend and I, she was my tour manager on the road, we would go into a different city, and after the show we'd try to go somewhere and connect with the local people or just try to have new experiences. And that really opened my eyes, just to see, even in Santa Barbara, which isn't far from Los Angeles, the different little things that people do. It really is. Right. It's an eye-opening experience just to see how the rest of the world lives.
This has been a momentous year for you. Congratulations, I hear you had a baby.
Yes.
That's great. So how are you managing motherhood and your singing career?
That's been tough, just because, I got the opportunity to go on the road this past year, and I had to leave my family behind, and they came to visit, which was amazing, but I did miss them a lot, and I try to balance the two, but it is really hard, when you're trying to build a career and you have a family too. But it's beautiful at the same time, just because my son is the best thing that has ever happened to me, and he inspires me every day, so he makes me want to do everything, to the nth degree.
That's great. Now, do you have any advice for anybody like yourself who's a young mother and trying to balance the career and the children?
There is a light at the end of the tunnel. It seems really hard a lot of the time, especially if you're a single mom, which I can't even imagine being. I have so much respect for single parents now. But there is a light at the end of the tunnel, and things get really hard. But like I said before, my son is the best thing that ever happened to me.
So is there anyone special out there as far as other artists who you'd be interested in working with in the future?
There are quite a few artists that I would love to work with. I would love to tour with Rufus Wainwright. I think that would be really fun for the both of us, because he is just so amazing. He's such a genius. I would love to work with him in any way possible. I would love to sing a duet with Michael Bublé, just because I love him. And I Just Haven't Met You Yet is one of my guilty pleasure songs. I don't know. There's so many people I'd love to work with, but I think right now I'm just trying to focus on getting my next tour, getting back in the studio, finishing another album, and keep going.
So what's next for you?
Right now I'm writing a lot of new material. I have a whole bunch of new material. I'm kind of trying to whittle it down and see what I want to go into the studio with next. Try to find a really good producer. My last album was I call it the Mutt album. It was almost a collection of demos. We worked with a bunch of different producers over a long period of time, so everything kind of sounds a little different. I mean, it works, it definitely works, but I want my second album to be just, a complete sound, just something different and something fun. So I'm in the process of looking for someone who I can work with to create that. Get back in the studio, either do a full-length album or an EP, you know, and try to get signed, shop that around, and get on tour. That's really what I want to do. I need to get back on the road. I'm a road dog now.
I'm sure there'll be many tours for you.
I hope so.
Now, where can people find your CD, Simple Beauty, and where can we catch up with you?
Simple Beauty is on iTunes. It's itunes.com/JaneCarreyBand. And also, I'm on Twitter, twitter.com/JaneCarreyBand, Facebook, and myspace.com/JaneCarreyBand. I'm everywhere. There's a social networking site. I am there. And I'm manning all the sites, so YouTube as well. So come find me, and I'll Twitter you back. I always say when I'm on stage, I tell them to Twitter me from the audience, because I'll be backstage, and I'll get the Twitters, and I'll just Twitter back, and I'm like, we're instant friends! So I get really excited.
Well, great. Well, I'll have to look for you on there. Your friend and follower.
Awesome.
Well, thank you so much, Jane, for being here. I wish you the best of luck. I love your music. It sounds so great. You're incredible. And I look forward to following your music career.
Thank you. Thank you very much for having me.
If you'd like to catch up with Jane and the Jane Carrey Band, she will be opening for Chuck Regan at the Barn at UC Riverside on October 13th. The address is 900 University Avenue, Riverside, California, 92507. All tickets are $12 and it's available for all ages. Doors open at 7:30 p.m. and the show starts at 8:30 p.m. Be sure to catch Jane and the Jane Carrey Band.